I welcome all of the students on behalf of MET Institute of Organic Agriculture. Today I will discuss about soil fertility evaluation methods. And earlier we discussed about soil testing, plant analysis, DRIS system of plant analysis, and chemical analysis. The topic of today is biological methods. What is the significance of biological method? Biological methods are easy to apply. Biological methods do not require many chemicals. Biological methods, farmers can also use biological methods to test the soil, whether the soil is low in nutrient status, medium in nutrient status, or high in nutrient status. So easy methods were developed to test the soils, and no laboratory is required, no many chemicals are required, so it is easy and rapid method of detection for soil fertility. So soil fertility is the capacity of soil or inherent potential of the soil for the growth and development of plant. And another term is soil productivity, in which we study about crop production. I show you this figure many times because he is Honorable Sir Justice Vaughan Levy. Justice Vaughan Levy is considered the father of agricultural chemistry. He gave a law that is called Levy's Law of Minimum. It clearly states that the nutrients which are least in amount, which are minimum in amount, are responsible for the yield or growth response of the plants. So the minimum amount of nutrients are the critical factor for determination of growth and yield of plants. Suppose this is a wooden bucket, and at one side the water is flowing at the lower level. So the minimum level or least amount or lower level are the critical factor, are the important factor which determines the growth and yield of a crop. That was called law of minimum. You can see the figures. Phosphorus is limiting factor in figure 1, potassium in figure 2, magnesium and sulfur are limiting factors in figure 3, and in figure 4 all are limiting because all have equal amount of dosage. Another term is law of diminishing return. It means that when we add inputs into our crop, into agriculture, the crop increases rapidly in the initial stage. The crop growth response is very high at initial stage, and this response decreases after further addition of the same inputs. Suppose applying X fertilizer, we are getting 50% yield. When we double the fertilizer 2X, the yield is not doubled. The yield is increasing from 50% to 75%. When the input is tripled, you can say X to 3X, the yield is not increasing from 50 to 150. It is going up to 100. So the increment means increase in yield. The increment is decreasing. The increment is decreasing by the further addition of inputs. When we apply fertilizer, successive doses of fertilizers, the yield is increasing very high at the initial stage, and then yield is now decreasing and at a certain point the yield is completely controlled. Yield is not increasing after 100. So we'll be adding further fertilizer inputs, the yield is not going to increase after a certain limit. So it was called law of diminishing return. So in law of diminishing return, we found that we increasing the one factor continuously or we increasing the one fertilizer continuously, but it is causing decrease in the increment. Percentage increase in the initial was very high and the increase is decreasing after further addition of the one factor. So Karl Marx said that law of diminishing return is tendency of the rate of profit to fall. The profit or increment is decreases after a level. Now we are studying the biological methods. It is number 3. What are the biological methods? Biological methods, we use higher plants and microorganisms to test the soil fertility. What are the concept of biological methods? The concept of biological methods is to make the procedure very simple, rapid and easy. In chemical analysis, we use many chemicals. We use a laboratory for chemical analysis. To overcome the problem, to minimize the use of chemical in practicals, biological methods were adapted. And in biological methods, we use indicator plants. Indicator plants are those plants which can absorb high amount of nutrients from soil. Similarly, indicator microorganisms can grow rapidly when they are fed with cultures or when the nutrients are made available to the microorganisms. They can grow very rapidly. The colony formation takes place rapidly. That are called indicator microorganisms. So we use plants as indicators for the status of soil fertility, and we also use microorganisms to test the soil fertility. The scientist name who gave the method is also included in this method. So we came to know that biological methods are simple, it is rapid or quick, and a small amount of soils are used and a small amount of chemicals are used to test the power of soil, to test the fertility of soil. Now we will discuss the methods. Like number 1 is Miskarlik pot culture method. In this method we use a crop that is called oat. Oat is a test crop. The seedlings are used. Seedlings means a small plant. 10 pots are used. In first pot, it is called control plot. No fertilizer is added. In the second pot, only nitrogen and phosphorus are added. Potassium is absent. In third plot, in third treatment, nitrogen and potassium are added and phosphorus is absent. And in fourth plot, all nutrients NPK are added. And we grow the oat crop and we check the yield percentage and we compare the readings. So if suppose there are two types, one is control. If the yield is similar in control and in number 4, NPK, then we can say that the soil is rich. The soil status is good because the yield in control is similar to the yield in NPK added fertilizers. But if there is difference, there is increase in control from the control to the NP or from the control to the NK or from the control to the NPK, the increase percentage increase is calculated and accordingly soil status is determined whether it is deficient, very deficient or not deficient. This is another technique that is called New Bauer seedling method. It was developed by Neubauer and Snyder in 1932. 100 seedlings are used in 100 gram soil. After 17 days, these plants are analyzed. These seedlings are analyzed and we observe phosphate and potassium uptake in the roots. And if the uptake is 20 milligram in 100 gram of the soil for potassium, it is considered good. If the uptake is less than 20 milligram for potassium, the soil is considered deficient. If the uptake is more than 20 milligram for potassium, the soil is considered rich potassium soil. Similarly, for phosphorus, if the level of phosphorus is calculated 3 milligram in the 100 gram tested soils, then it is called satisfactory level. If the level is below 3 milligram of phosphorus, then it is said the soil is deficient in phosphorus, and if the level is more than 3 milligram, then it is considered rich phosphorus soils. This is sunflower pot culture method. We test boron deficiency. What we do? We grow sunflower in 500 gram soils in a small pots. We apply all nutrients like nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, and we do not provide boron because we are checking boron deficiency. So we do not add boron in the experiment. And after 28 days, we check if the boron deficiency appears within 28 days, then it is called very high deficiency of boron. If the boron deficiency appears between 28 to 36 days, then we call moderate boron deficient soil. And if boron deficiency does not occur till 36 days or more, then there is no deficiency of boron in the soil. Now, microbiological test. Some microbes like Azotobacter, Aspergillus are very sensitive to the nutrients. If there is high level of nutrient in soil, they can grow very rapidly. Their colony formation takes place very rapidly. And if the nutrient is low, their colony formation is also low. So we measure the amount of their colony, we measure the weight of their colony or diameter of the colony, and we test the soil status. Azotobacter plaque method. Here is a spelling mistake of plaque, PLAQUE. It was developed by Sackett and Stewart in 1931. Before 1931, Vinogradsky, the Russian scientist, observed that Azotobacter is very sensitive to phosphorus. And he first conducted this experiment. 4 petri dishes is taken. He 50 gram soils are kept in all petri dishes. We add potassium sulfate to test the potassium deficiency. We add sodium hydrogen phosphate to test the phosphorus deficiency. We add potassium hydrogen phosphate to test the deficiency of potassium and phosphate both. And there is a control plot in which we do not add any chemicals, any nutrient. The soil is incubated with Azotobacter for 72 hours. Why it is incubated? Soil is incubated with microorganisms so that microorganisms can feed these nutrients. Microorganisms use these nutrients and they grow. The colony develops after feeding the nutrients. After microorganisms feed on the nutrients, they culture on the nutrients, they grow rapidly, and we check, we determine the amount of colony growth. How we measure? You can see in detail how it is measured. It is measured, it is seen here. When the colonies are very low, when there is no colony or very small pinpoint colonies are there in the control, unfertilized means control. Where is low amount of, very low amount of colony on the control, then we say it is very deficient soil. Moderately deficient, when some amount of colonies, very weak colonies are present without no pigment on the control, then we say it is moderately deficient soil. And when there are colonies on unfertilized plaques are equal to the number of colonies on the fertilized plaques, means when the number of colonies are equal on the control as well as in the nutrient media, then we say the it is slightly deficient soil. And the other last is not deficient, when the colonies on both fertilized and unfertilized plaques are equal in number, they are very good in number and their color is pink. So we can say the soil is good on behalf of potassium and phosphorus. So if there is no difference between control and the fertilizer applied, then it is said that soil condition is good for potassium and phosphorus. This is other technique called Mehlich technique for available potassium in soil. Here a fungus is used that is called Aspergillus niger. The growth of fungus is called mycelial pad. Mycelia is the growth of hypha, and mycelia grow because of the nutrients provided to the culture and incubation period. And if the growth of mycelia is more than 2 gram, then it is said that soil is not deficient in potassium. If the mycelial growth is less than 1.5 gram, then it is said the soil is very deficient in potassium. The third method is called Mehlich's Cunning-Mela plaque method for phosphorus determination. In this method, this is a microorganism, Cunning-Mela, which is very sensitive to phosphorus. That means if phosphorus is available, they can grow very well. If phosphorus is deficient, the species do not grow properly. And if the phosphorus level is very high, the growth of Kalingmela is very high. This is also a fungus, so we check mycelial growth. If the diameter of the colony is less than 10 millimeter, then we say that the soil is phosphorus deficient, very deficient. And if the level of mycelium diameter is more than 22 centimeter, then we say that the soil is not deficient. The soil is good for phosphorus content. So, these are the methods for biological test. In biological test, we grow plants and we check the response. If the growth is very good, then the soil is very good. If the growth of plants or microorganism is not good, then the soil status is not good. So, we compare the growth of indicator plants or indicator microorganisms, and we correlate the growth of colonies of microorganism with the status of soil fertility. If the colonies are good, if the colonies are well developed, then we say that our soil is good, our soil is not deficient. And if the colonies are poor, then we say that our soil is deficient in the nutrients. Some other names are also, other techniques are also used, like field plot method. In field plot method, we conduct experiment. We grow plants, we take the field locations area, they are called replications, and different treatments are applied as per need of the experiment. And we conduct large number of experiments on the field to check the nutrient status of different nutrients. Another name is a strip test on farmer's field. There are farmer's field all over in agricultural land. And the researchers or the scientists go to the laboratory to test the some area that is called a strip area. A strip means long area, long rectangular shape area may be taken as a strip. So some area as a sample are tested. And there is experiment is grown on the farmer's field, and the, some fertilizer are added to test that whether the soil is deficient of this fertilizer or not. Suppose we are going to test the sulfur fertilizer, we can use elemental sulfur to test whether the soil is deficient of sulfur or not. We can use other nutrients to test whether the soil is deficient of that nutrient or not. Another is called greenhouse test. In greenhouse test, we use the sample of greenhouse. We use the soil samples of the greenhouse, and that is called greenhouse soil test. And the tests are used for soil pH, electrical conductivity, NPK, and micro elements as well. So these were the tests, and now we are open for discussion. Thank you.